Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, dear viewers. Welcome back to Technology of Baitalha once again. So now, let's move towards the if-else statements. While we are working on programming in some languages, just like C++, okay? And if we are talking about managing conditions within the code, then we have to manage it with if conditions. So if we talk about the flow of the program with the help of if conditions, it's just like this. If we talk about if we have some condition in it, okay, it means after that whether the condition will be true. If the condition will be true, then we will move towards this statement. So if the condition is not true, then this statement will not be executed. Let's take the flow of the program is just like this. If we are using the if condition, okay, firstly the syntax is if, after that in parenthesis we have some condition, okay, and within the parenthesis that condition either it will be true or it will be false. So after that, if the condition is true, then the body of if will be executed. So whatever the statement or the multiple statements in it, that will be executed on the basis of condition. Whenever the condition is true, then they display this portion of code. And remember one more thing, in if condition we have some operators here. And which are the operators we can use within the if condition? And these are like, if a equals 5, we use double equal symbols for equality here. After that, greater than sign, if a is greater than 5, if a less than 5, if a is greater or equals to 5, if a less than or equals to 5, or if a is not equals to 5, and after that, if not a. These all are the operators we can use within the if condition. So we have an example just like this. The input marks from the user and display if he is passed. That means we need some variable marks, okay, and we have to assign some value from the user into the marks variable, and after that we have to apply this if condition on the marks variable. Suppose just like if marks is greater than 49. It means if this condition will be true, then we have to display the you are pass. So now moving towards the whole program. So after the header files in the main function, we have declared integer variable, that is marks. And after that, we have to display enter your numbers. So it will be displayed. It's just like this. Then we have to seen marks. Input the marks from the user. Whatever the user input here, now suppose the user input here the 55 marks, okay, then the 55 will be assigned to the marks variable, and after that the program checks the condition. Which condition? That is if the marks is greater than 49. So in this case 55 is greater than 49, the condition is true. Now so if the condition is true, then this portion of the if will be executed, that is cout you are pass. So finally the output of this code is you are pass if the user passing the value is 55. Now let's suppose take another example within this program. Suppose if user enters his marks 35, so 35 will be assigned to variable marks, okay, and after that then condition will be marks greater than 49. That means 35 is greater than 49. The condition will be false now. So the body of the if will not be executed now. So we are not displaying anything else. Now let's move towards if and else. Okay, now it's just like if the condition is true, then the execution will be on this statement, and then this statement will be executed. And if the condition will be false, then we have to display any other statement, okay, just like this. So for this purpose we use the else as well with the if condition. Now we have another example. It's just like input the number from the user and display either he is the pass or the fail now. Right now, we have to check if he is pass. We can also show that if he is fail. So let's take this program. The program says we use the if condition, and the condition will be the same if marks is greater than 49. If that condition will be true, then we have to display you are pass. So suppose if we have this program, okay, and what will be the execution of this program? Firstly, after the header file in the main function, the execution on the again integer marks, we input the marks from user. Suppose once again enter your marks, and after that user have to enter some marks. And suppose user enters 35 marks, okay, so 35 will be assigned to the marks variable. And after that, now the condition is checked. What's the condition right now? Marks is greater than 49. That means we have the value 35 in marks. The condition should be now the 35 is greater than 49. The condition is false now. If the condition is false now, then the portion of if will not be executed. Then the program executes the else part of the program. Okay now, so moving towards the else part, and after that, in else part, we have to display you are fail. So in this case, the condition will be false, and we are moving towards the else part, and in else part, what will be displayed here? The output of this code is, now you are fail, when the user enters 35 marks. Let's take another example once again, because as much as you practice, it will be more beneficial for you while you are performing some programming. Now moving towards this example, suppose we have input the age from the user and display either he is eligible for casting the vote or not eligible. Got it? Now moving towards the code, suppose this is the code for this scenario. Now what's the execution of this program? Firstly, we have to say that please enter your age. Okay, display the enter your age, the output will be here. And after that, user have to input some value. Okay, suppose if the user enters 22 here, his age is 22 for example, so 22 will be assigned to the age variable. Okay, and after that the condition will be checked. So what is the if condition here? Here is the if condition: if age is greater or equals to 18. Now in this case, check either this condition will be true or not. Suppose in age variable we have right now 22, okay, the user input 22. Now the 22 is greater or equals to 18. Condition is true now. Actually this condition is true. So if the condition is true, then we have to display you can vote. Okay, the output of this code is you can vote. Actually he is eligible because his age is 22. So let's take another example within this program. If the user enters his age is 16. Okay, so if the age is 16, then what will be the execution here? If the user enters 16 age, then the 16 will be assigned to the age variable. Okay, after that condition will be checked. What condition says? It says if the age is greater or equals to 18. Now check the condition: if 16 is greater or equals to 18. Now the condition is false now. 16 is not greater than 18. Okay, so which portion is executed now? If portion or the portion of else? Obviously the else portion will be executed. So moving towards the else part, and after that in else part the code displays you cannot vote. So finally the output of this program, while user input the 16 age, this program displays you cannot vote. So actually this was the purpose of if conditions. We deal with it, and after that we practice it with the different examples with the help of code. Thank you so much for watching.